Oh, I added on that sale ball. 3 hours and 40 minutes. Yeah, sir. So, again, I'm gonna fuck around for a little while. If anybody wants to join me, please. Otherwise, I'm just gonna play some music and fuck off while I'm editing. I had a good time tonight. Tonight was a good show. I'm looking forward to fucking listening back to some of these goddamn songs that we were fucking singing. Wiener's on fucking days right now. He's working days, so. Wiener's probably snuggled up to his fucking girlfriend. Getting that snuggle. I did have Candy over here today, though. Yeah, he's gonna come through on the weekend. And we're gonna do a fucking special show with his ass. And definitely him and his brother will be in Chicago. If and when the fucking wrestling soup shit goes down. We're all gonna be there. Dogs, Kenny. Wiener's talking about it. Wiener said it, if it's on a weekend, he's down. You know, so plenty of fucking room in the car. But we'll be there. So make sure you fucking book that goddamn plane ticket, Emo Hill. Or Evan Pike. Evan Pike. What's up, Santos? I can't wait to make them dog meetings. Hell yeah, dude. Resident soup tomorrow. Pineapple ham. No, pineapple and tomato pizza is what fucking rocks. Pineapple and fucking tomato. That's a fucking shit. Keep that fucking fake goddamn Canadian bacon to yourself.
In moments like this, you want to enjoy the time that applies the most.
Trying to.
Introducing the new one-touch VarioFlex meter.
Yes!
It helps take the guesswork out of your blood glucose numbers.
Finally!
Color Shore technology.
Been waiting for it.
This easy-to-use meter has a compact, slim design
that
fits
yeah.
into your hand and
yeah.
your life.
Hey.
Start testing with the new one-touch VarioFlex meter
yeah.
at no charge today.
Oh, yeah!
One
it detects herpes,
every
too.
Touch is a step forward.
And the hip.
I'm going to go ahead and ram it. I hope you don't mind.
All right, go ahead.
Yeah. Let's get some music for that ramming.
You motherfuckers. Eat by two. All right, come on, man. Somebody call in or else I'm going to be a good motherfucker. Just hang up this shit. Brett, you son of a bitch. Michael Corvin, you called in before. Time to call in again. Come on. Come on, bitches. Come on, bitches. I promise. You call in, I'll make sure Evan doesn't bite. You hear how sure? That's how sure I am about it. I slur about it. Seriously, Brett, call your motherfucking ass up. Oh, what's up, Boots?
You said to call, so I called.
Oh, I can always count on you, can't I?
Yeah, I just show up late, that's all.
Yeah, turn that background music off.
I did. I was having trouble, but I did it. I figured it out.
As much trouble as Mark and Detroit's new girlfriend is having right now?
Probably not that much trouble.
So what's up, Boots? How's your wiener?
It's good.
Okay.
It's good. Wiener-like.
Yeah. Like yeah. wiener? My friend wiener-like? Or? No, not that wiener-like.
No, not that kind of wiener.
Not creepy?
Not.
Lurking?
My wiener's good.
You know why he wants to be president?
To get girls?
That's probably a good answer.
Is that right? Why does he want to become president? What were you going to say?
I was going to say whatever you said was probably a good idea because I never thought about it before.
Yeah, I feel like that's probably why. I think he probably thinks he could, like, do some good.
Man, as long as I get motorcycle bitches, I'll be your president. Should we call Wiener? Let's
yeah,
call Wiener and wake his ass up.
Call Wiener.
I was like, dude. I told Wiener, I'm like, dude. The only, I know fucking 3 phone numbers and Wiener's is one of them.
The music that you were playing earlier, what was the
yeah, we
Mark? The Mark is gonna love you song that you were singing.
Yeah.
Oh my God, so good. That like the music that you were playing with it. I mean, your freestyling wasn't particularly excellent.
Fuck you! Now, fuck off! Christ. Now I'm going to put your boyfriend, I mean, your fucking wannabe boyfriend on the phone here, Mr. King Wiener. Fucking trying to help you out.
Wiener, pick up the phone.
There, he did.
Wiener.
Oh. Wiener. Who is this?
It's Sarah. It's Boots.
Huh?
It's Boots.
Oh, Boots.
Wiener.
Boots.
What are you doing?
What am I doing? I'm sitting here at the house.
Why?
With my clothes off.
Why aren't you over at Yuck's house? Don't you know it's podcast night?
Yuck's angry at me.
Oh yeah, when did that start, asshole?
They're calling me a faggot.
Exactly. I've been pissing him since the first time I met him.
That sounds about right.
Right. The Boots, are your pants off?
Yep.
Wiener, right
it's
away.
Wednesday night, I'm at home. It's no pants time.
He's all Marky Detroit right away.
Yeah, he is.
Marky Detroit is a verb. We're going to make Wiener a verb, too. Wiener, we've been getting requests for you to come back in the corner, man. I told you, baby.
No.
Huh?
I said I didn't know.
Why
what
did you stop
you
coming
you
to
the
corner?
No. Are you working days now?
I'm on night still.
Oh, that was just last week?
Yeah.
Yeah, dude, I just talked to you last week about taking my mom to the strip club on her birthday. What the fuck you mean?
No, you asked me if I wanted to have sex with your mom.
Oh, yeah. You know, dude, I was driving. Yeah, I mean, her and him. I'll just ignore that, you know. That's one of the things. You just keep quiet. I've known Wiener for a long time. I just, you know.
Oh,
Wiener,
yeah.
My mom, as soon as, I was like, yeah, Wiener said I should take you to the strip club. And she was like, tell Wiener to tell me where they are. And I need to text you that. Like, seriously. She's like, tell Wiener I need to know where they're located. And I did not pick up my phone. And like a half hour later, she's like, are you going to text Wiener that?
Right.
I mean,
awesome.
Serious. She thought it was a good joke that you would enjoy. What are you,
okay.
What are you doing, man?
What am I doing?
Yeah, making it.
I'm in the bed.
Right on.
What are you doing?
Talking to Boots, broadcasting on the corner. Say hi to everybody.
Hello.
And Boots, and one thing Boots and I have been trying to figure out, one question for real that we're just asking ourselves, why do you want to be president, Wiener?
Why do I want to be president?
Mayor or whatever.
Oh. Yeah, well, fix the country. Get everything back in order.
I told you, do some good. I said do some good.
Yes.
You said do some good right after you said get some bitches.
That's true, I did. I said both of those things.
She knows you too well, Wiener.
Why?
It's because Wiener and I are soulmates.
All right, well, think about me and Boots when you're whacking off, partner.
Oh, I will.
And Evan.
Already happening.
And Evan. Are you sitting there, Boots?
Yeah. Did you hang up on him?
Yeah. You nice. Tell he was getting a little pissy. I know I'm a little too well.
Oh, Wiener.
Boots! This is Boots! That motherfucker got excited, didn't he?
A little bit.
Oh,
little
yeah.
I mean.
Oh, here we go. Oh, shit. See? I forget about hitting add to call.
Oh. I want to talk to Max Cole.
All right, hold on. I'm going to hang up on you, and I'm going to call you right back. Boots.
Why'd you put me on hold?
Because I hit the wrong fucking button.
Way to go, man.
Motherfucker, I can't just hit answer. I gotta hit add to group.
Who are you adding to group?
It's been a long time since I've been all fucking bubbly like this. Doing some after party shit. Motherfuckers.
I know.
Oh my god.
I have to say I really missed after partying.
Hold on, I gotta call Emo.
Okay.
You heard that, didn't you, Emo?
Yeah.
Wait a minute. What? Yeah, the fucking group. Hold on.
Just having so much trouble.
Actually, Evan, just call and then I can add you. Because I'm already hosting. Oh, here we go. See, everything's so fucking complicated. I got like 14 fucking recent things that has Evan's face in it. And I can't fucking add him.
Can't pick the right one.
I talked to him 2 days ago.
Fuck. Where's Max Cole?
I don't know,
where's Max?
In the chat room?
Where's
Shout
Max
out to
Cole.
Max Cole. Is he in the chat room?
Yeah. Adam, he's around.
Max, call in.
Oh man, everybody
that
wants
chocolate healing right now.
Hey.
Why are you feeling injured?
Yeah.
You know that chocolate healing helps you. Man, it's better than a chiropractor.
Dude, he can just talk to my back, and it won't feel as bad as it does right now.
See, man, I get all deep like it, and I try to be all chocolate with it, but I can't because I'm a white boy. I try my best. I can interpret in the hood, just like Dog said.
If you look like you do in your picture there, you would be a magician still.
A magician?
Yeah, you look like a magician.
With my fucking senior year picture? Yeah.
Like a magician? What are you talking about?
Dude, the picture that I have for my twat box, I put it on the Peter Peters on the Facebook. I put it on the Peter Peters. You knew what I was talking about. Bitch. Do I gotta fucking hit that fucking sound clip?
No, not sound clip.
Dude, I got a long face. Pretty little fuck. Look how long my bangs come way past my ear. And if they weren't curling, they would have fucking came down like what shit.
I came down all over those curls.
Ah, yeah, all over that chin. Look at that big old chin on me. Yeah. Follow me on the twat box. That's twitter.com/
nasty_. Where's Max Cole?
Dude, he says, man, he's busy right now taking care of some other lovely.
Damn it.
Man, he tweeted
Mike,
me. He's
well,
like,
first,
man.
Michael Corbin. I want to talk to Michael Corbin. I've never talked to him in, like, a long time. I think I talked to him once, maybe.
Yeah, he called in and talked to us once.
Yeah, call in, Michael. Call in.
Yeah, we
Why
were calling
him. Why
are you
so aggro when
we were calling him
call
the heel of wrestling soup. Don't you remember, Drone?
Uh-huh.
Like I was a drone, but I didn't. I didn't think of, oh, my God. Hey, you hit me with that.
Colleen.
Yeah, man, for real, man. I'm
Russell.
So sick of
Let's talk to Russell.
Talking to boots. And
Why? No, you're not sick
Evan
of talking
all
to
the
me.
Time. I want someone new.
Yeah, I'm done with talking to boots.
Hold on. 773 area code. Who the fuck are you?
Oh, that's good,
this
Matt.
This is Corbin. This better be good, Evan. I was just about to go to sleep. So what,
what are you wearing? Are you wearing PJ bottoms right now?
No, I'm actually just wearing nothing at all. Just for
no
you.
No pants.
Okay?
No pants. See, Michael Corbin knows it's no pants time, too.
It's fucking like 77 degrees outside and fucking hot as hell in the pool of my head, bro.
Man,
yeah.
See?
Tell me more, Michael.
Of course.
More.
No, you're creepy enough. You don't trust you Canadians.
Why? You're too friendly. And we're not like
you're too
friendly, like we're gonna stab you in the back, but I might stab you.
You're too happy and friendly. I don't trust people like that. You're just too happy and just. I don't know what it is like.
Trust
you're always
me.
Happy.
Did you just describe
trust
Evan
me,
as
Evan?
Happy.
I was gonna say Evan Hill is not happy, bro.
Oh, whatever. He's too positive, upbeat. He's too upbeat. For me, right?
No. You are talking. You may be talking about his neighbor down the block, but not Evan Hill.
I think he's talking about Kevin Gill.
Kevin Gill,
he's one of the happiest motherfuckers you'll ever meet.
He's got a big dick.
Yeah, but Evan Hill got a small dick.
Oh, we know.
He's always mad.
Michael Corbin.
I don't really care. I don't care what you have. I don't interest me at all.
Why not?
Because, Michael, man, we don't care about your penis. We care about our own penises. We don't give a fuck about your Canadian fucking little dicks.
My maple leaf?
Yeah, whatever you gotta fucking call it.
Or whatever you cover it with, I don't care.
But don't you call fucking chicks? They have beavers in America, don't they?
Oh yeah, man. Here in Wisconsin, there's actually a town called Beaver.
Of course there is.
I swear to God, like, seriously, you gotta go through, hold on. There's a town called Pound, there's a town called Beaver, and there's a town called Spread Eagle, right? And this, and it actually goes in the order of going up the same highway to where you pound, you spread your eagle and then you pound the beaver. Wow. I swear to God, man, it's something like that. If Dogger was here, he'd be like, oh yeah, let me tell you all about it. Cause...
Where's Corbin in Chicago?
Yeah, 773 yeah. Chicago.
Where I am.
You gonna come out to if we come there and the soup and everybody does the live podcast, you're gonna be there.
I'll be there. I can get
nice.
To the place for that.
Man, I was gonna say I'll bring you some black guys from the hood and they just gotta show you dicks and no one will fuck with you, baby. All the white guys, see, as soon as they see a black guy's dick, they just get scared immediately, right?
See, stuff like that makes me not want to show up to the live podcast if you jokes are going to be there, because that's just going to be weird for everybody.
Dude, I'm just fucking around, babe. We can snuggle. I can sit on your lap, man. Wait till you see how little I am. I'm just a harmless, like, you can flick me like a flea, man. I'm harmless.
I'm already weary of going. Anybody even finds out who I am, we're all gonna be yelling.
You have
I'm probably gonna get jumped for leaving shitty voicemails from the suit.
Man, fuck that, man. Oh, nobody cares, man. It's all fun, dude. I think people just talk shit before you.
You have nice long flowing locks though that I can brush, or else I'm not going.
I'm bald, so he needs some horniness.
I'm bald too, so fucking I need to stroke somebody's hair. Sarah's out.
You coming?
Am I coming?
Yes, he is.
Is Boots coming yet? Is Boots coming to the live podcast taping?
Yes, Boots is coming, even if Evan doesn't.
Well, Evan, you can stroke Boots' hair, or Dogger, or Yuck will wear a wig or something.
Dogger has some nice thick curls.
Oh my gosh, Yuck, you gotta wear a wig.
I didn't ask for them.
Dude, I'll wear a wig. You damn right.
I asked
for
you, Corbin. I didn't ask for them.
He's already seen us.
Yeah, I don't have long hair.
I'm asking for you.
Well, you could use my wig, Michael Corbin.
I don't know.
All right, then. I'll just put my ass on your face, and my ass hair can make a wig.
You won't even have a chance to do that. It's not
going to
happen.
You just hold
hands? Dude, I will hold your hand, man.
No, I've held more than your hand. I'm asking Corbin.
I held Dogger's hand twice tonight. If we had the video on, you would have seen it.
Why don't you have the video on anymore?
Fuck up! There's guys talking! Grown folks! Okay, woman?
Hey, bitch, we let you fucking both not speak.
All right, Mike,
somebody's
man.
Somebody's angry tonight.
No, man. I'm just screaming.
I thought you were... I was happy to go lucky Evan Hill all of a sudden. Now I'm yelling and screaming. What the fuck do you want, Corbin? What do you want from me?
I don't know. What do you want? You're the one who wanted me to call in.
Yeah.
I just want to be your pal.
You should call in more often, honestly. You hear me talking. Call into the corner more often. Last time you fucking talked to Evan and I for like, it was like an hour and a half, dude.
Yeah.
I'm going to be starting a job, and you guys are on in the middle of the week, so I really can't do that.
Right on, no doubt. Well, I'm just letting
you
know. Look
crazy hours.
Okay, well, that motherfucking invitation never dies, bro.
Come on sometime.
I will try to call in as often as I can if I'm able to.
Even once in a while.
I'll at least listen to the show more often than I do.
Thank you, man.
It's good to have you around, though, man. I always stick up for you. You know that.
I think.
Michael.
Sure you do.
Evan.
Actually, in all the soup, everyone's like, I hate Corbin. I'm like, go, Corbin. And I'm like, always cheering him on.
Well, that's because I think you're one of those people who can fight seeing the chaos unfold.
Yes, he is.
I think you actually kind of enjoy people getting pissed at my voice.
That's exactly him, dude. He fucking sets the fucking scene and just watch it all fucking demolish. Even if motherfuckers that he's supposedly friends with are like, you fucking asshole, you really don't like that? He's over here laughing like a fucking troll.
Well, Some people just like to see the world burn.
Pretty much,
Basically, he's just an orphan.
Well, you
you can't take him seriously in the fucking
You gotta keep things interesting, right?
Look, I'm not mad at you, I'm just saying that's kind of what you, I think that's kind of your thing.
Yeah, that is his thing.
So we're not gonna
just like, you like seeing the chaos before, which I don't mind, but,
Alright, Mike, man, thank you for calling in, man. We can barely hear you. We're honestly listening and finding out what you say through every fucking chop of your audio. We're used to stutters.
I can't hear Evan that well. I can hear you guys fine, but I can't hear Evan that well, so.
Yeah.
Jeez, I don't know.
Man, thank you again.
I blame all of Canada. I blame Evan. I blame Canada. I'll talk to you guys next time.
Cheers, bud.
Yeah, I fucking blame fucking Canada, Evan, and fucking Dogger, especially.
Sorry.
I was gonna say, man, we're used to people fucking stuttering, so the audience understood most of what he was talking about, right?
They're used to, like, figuring it out.
Alright, who is Luke V? We got a Luke V motherfucking trying to call.
Call
back in, Luke V. Call back in. I just fucking accepted the motherfucking details.
Oh my god, that sounds pretty fucking intoxicating.
You know what, should I put the motherfucking effect back on? Oh. And no, this is not auto-tune, man.
What is it?
Church, like you're standing in a church. Church. Hello.
Breathe heavily.
Jesus loves me, this I know. Mark in Detroit, he told me so. When he tied me up, he said, I'll bring you dinner before I fuck you.
Remember dead hands, her mouth tape shut.
Dude, see, man, we be talking this much shit about Mark in Detroit, and he still comes back smiling.
He attacked me. He says, like, call in, Evan, call in, and I'll attack you. And I was like, commander, Brad, hit.
Now, do you understand what I'm saying? Like, dude, we be fucking with him so bad, and he still calls in just talking shit. I doubt his fucking girlfriend. Really on meth, obviously.
Meth is a hell of a drug. Call in.
Yeah, dude. He fucking pushes motherfuckers' buttons. I love it. I love it. Especially hearing Jill talk about it.
I really want to hear I really want to say hi to Max Colt so I have something to jerk off to before bed.
Oh, yeah.
Me too.
Max. Whoa! Her too.
Yeah, Max, me and her would be like, me and Sarah are gonna jerk off together. I'm like, remember when Max called said hi to me first?
No. What's gonna happen is both of you are gonna hang up, listen live, and whack off on video together.
Hey.
We have to actually, like, have correspondence with him or else it doesn't count.
Well, no, you listen to me and fucking, Max Cole.
So you're trying to hoard Max all to yourself?
I was just trying to set you up so you and Boots could Skype and beat off together.
That can happen after.
If I had a dick, this is where I tell you to suck it.
See, you ain't following me.
I need to hear Max Cole say, hey, Evan, how's it going? I'll be like, hi, Max.
Hi.
Remember when you did that movie and then you said hi to me? Aww.
and then he makes the vinegar face.
Yeah, man, we need to have when Max comes back on, we need to have him give out all the links to everything that he.
Oh, he says he's about to call in.
Right now, yeah, yeah.
Hey.
He might have been driving a Carl's Jr., man. He likes Carl's Jr.
Put on some sexy music for it.
Oh my God, Boots! Calm the fuck down. Yeah, Max, you're making his girlfriend horny, brother.
We should hang up on Sarah so me and you can hoard Max to ourselves.
I don't know. I might hang up on you because me and Boots might be more entertaining with Max Cole for the audience.
That's,
That's true.
Evan's gonna hang up right now.
No.
I'm gonna pet myself.
No, just hang up, bro.
Don't do that.
Oh yeah. Perfect fucking song for Max Cole.
Is this The Weeknd? It sounds like The Weeknd.
No, it's not The Weeknd. It's just a beat.
Oh really?
Dogger was singing. Dogger and I was singing. Teach you how to fuck.
The Mark song.
Oh, is this the one you were talking about?
Love you.
Oh, look at her. What'd you just say? Hold on, let me hear that again.
Are you gonna record it? Love you. It's totally gonna be stuck in my head now.
You like how I? Did you hear how I just started the whole recording off, just playing that over and over?
It's totally gonna be stuck in my head now. Okay. For hours.
For hours. That sounds like a
it's
fucking Vermont gangbang accent. Fucking getting the gangbang.
Sarah's been in the club.
No, you've been at the sex club. That was in Canada, though, right?
Yeah, that was in
Canada. You fucked one dude dressed as Santa Claus in a sex club. They call you a slut.
I did not have sex
with
him.
Oh, here we go. The motherfucking man of the hour.
Y'all are crazy.
Oh, there it is. I'm gonna try to act like him, but motherfucking area, I can't do it. Max Cole up in his motherfucking bitch. Welcome back to the corner.
How you guys doing tonight?
We're doing real good now that we can hear that shit. Oh, fuck yeah.
Hi, Max.
How's it going? Yo, I had cracking up. I was in the car. I almost drove off the road.
Well, we help motherfuckers lose a couple brain cells. You know, that might happen.
There's been a few get recorder deaths.
First off, it was Dogger's grandma.
Thanks for inviting me on the corner, you know. It's good to be here, hang out with all you.
You know, I didn't even think about you, but all of a sudden, she was like, man, bring that black guy back home with that lead voice, man. I want to, before I go to bed.
No, first it was Evan who said that. Evan, I'm just like, yes, also.
All right, hold on, one at a time. Boots.
It was Evan's idea. I was just like, I also would like that.
Yeah, I would like that. That's what she said.
We can do some private consultations.
Thanks, Max.
Woo! I thought I heard someone go, oh! Yeah, that was you. I knew you could hit that that fucking note, you goddamn motherfucking soprano ass dude. So what's up, Max? How you feeling tonight, man?
Oh, man, I'm feeling good, you know, just hanging out here. I did a cast, did a podcast a little bit ago.
What podcast?
Read just my show, you know, just had a comedian on tonight and chatting up. I gotta bring you on the show.
Okay, now you got a fucking show? Yeah, all right, man. This is the first time we're hearing about it. Shout the fucking
what's your show?
Exactly, dude. What is the link?
I dropped it I dropped it last time I was on the show.
Yeah, I was gonna say.
Goddamn Boots, shut the fuck up. Grown folks are talking, remember? Yeah. I was trying to give him a good segue, but
you're killing me. It's you're funny.
after dark one.
Yes, after dark. Yeah, you know, we talk some film, with some folks in the independent film community. So, yeah, we talk all kinds of stuff though. You know, I like to get in and chat it up a bit.
And that's on YouTube. It's on Stitcher.
No, it's Stitcher. Also
iTunes.
Obviously iTunes and Google Play. So.
You don't do anything on YouTube yet?
Not yet. You know, I'm not a fan of YouTube yet. I mean, I like it sometimes, but yeah, I don't know. I'm still sort of on the fence with
all
that.
All right, what about shit that you've done? Because I always talk about you being a film guy. So, I mean, is there anything on YouTube that you produced, directed? I mean, give those links out.
Man, I should do that. I need to give some stuff out. My website's MaxColeFilms.com, but I need to... What I need to do, though, is get some stuff for you all to see at some point here because, yeah, I've been working on a lot of stuff. I'm actually going to be releasing a ton of films this year, a lot of short films, and then I'm working on feature projects. So I'm looking forward to getting some stuff in the theater. So I've been reviewing a lot of screenplays, reading too many damn screenplays. But, yeah, I'm looking forward to it. So, and I got to get your ass in a film. And, Doggy, you guys got to be in a film.
Yes.
I got a question for you, Max.
Yeah, absolutely.
So, like, that After Dark Film Fest, are you associated with that then?
No, I'm not. Yeah, unfortunately, I'm not associated with that. But yeah, yeah.
I know that was all B-rated horror movies that were that come out yearly, right? And
yeah.
They just have a little film, independent film festival that they release those. So I thought that's what you were in. Sorry.
No, it's you know, it's a film podcast.
Man, but, he's way too sexy for that shit, Evan. God damn, what's wrong with you, baby?
I was just asking a reasonable question for once.
For once. Hey, Max, what is your podcast again? Tell us all one more time.
Cinema After Dark, yeah. At Cinema After Dark on Twitter. You can just go to cinemaafterdark.com. Listen to some of those episodes. You'll hear me cracking it up with some folks in the independent film community. But it's an inspirational show. You know, we try to bring on guests that have some skin in the game, that are doing their thing in the film industry, and want to share their stories. So it's, you know.
Is it only available download, or do you guys are going you live or no?
Yeah. Well, you know what? It's actually available to download, but I'm thinking about doing it live at some point here. You know, got to build an audience, got to build the right audience for that. You know, got to try to.
Well, the audience is ruined now. You're on the corner.
Well,
you might get some motherfuckers. Exactly. Hell
we
yeah.
have the ability to go live, so there will be some live discussions, and there is a, you know, stream on TuneIn, and that's running 24/7. Cool.
How many episodes deep are you?
Man, I'm in like 50 some episodes now.
Jesus
yeah.
Christ, man.
It's crazy. I've been putting in too many damn hours.
Yeah,
it's crazy.
The top five.
Say it again. Say it one more time.
Can I have your top five?
That ooh, that's a hard.
Send to.
Damn. You know, every episode, you know, and I hate to be cliche like that, but I believe that every episode is unique because, you know, these stories that people are sharing are so personalized, and
can you pick at least, like, your top 10 favorite, maybe, that you've done?
Yeah, or, I mean, guests that you had a lot of fun with. It doesn't have to be your favorite.
Guests are so damn fun. It's hard for me to do that because all the guests, I swear, are just, they're excellent. So, I hate to do that injustice. I always bite my tongue when I do that because I go back. It's like me with movies. I'll go back and I'll be pissed off that I didn't.
So you better listen to every fucking 50 plus episodes, assholes.
Listen to the last five episodes. There are some good ones in there. A couple Oscar winners and.
Oh yeah, I mean yeah. Tell us more guests. What other guests? Tell us
about. Name drop.
Yeah, man, name drop that shit, bro.
I'm such a bad name dropper. God, you listen to Todd and Jed White or. Jeff Consiglio was on the show. We've had such interesting guests. I had a wonderful comedian recently, India Pearl, who was on the show.
And she's Pearl?
Yeah, India Pearl. Mila Hudson was an actress who did a fantastic short film that was on the show recently, too, as well. There's been some, you know, these guests, I have to give hats off to everybody. And because the thing is that they tell their stories, you know, it's hard to do sometimes. And people think film is simple. We kind of go behind the scenes and we, you know, pull the curtain back a bit and you know, tell you what happens, you know, behind the scenes and some of these crazy situations people get themselves into, but some inspiring situations too as well. So cinema's an interesting beast like that. And folks are working. It's a grind, no doubt about that. I mean, when you see someone on TV or, you know, on the screen, there's so much work that goes into that, so much legwork that really goes into that whole process. And, you know, they call LA a 10-year city for a reason, because that's the truth.
Fucking put that legwork in.
Did you grow up in LA or?
No, I didn't. I grew up in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. I'm an East Coast guy.
Wait a minute. I thought you said, all right. I might bring up something that we talked about in the End of Days chat room. Again, Max Cole is sponsored by End of Days Radio. Make sure you check out endofdaysradio.com, motherfuckers. The chat box that we be in on Twitter, man. Did you say you went to school with,
Zach Quinto?
Yeah, right?
Yeah, Spock.
Spock from the, and dude from Heroes, right?
Yeah, right. I remember that, man. You remember everything, I swear.
Dude, I got a good memory.
You know what I think?
What's up?
I think Max Cole's voice turned Spock gay. He's gay.
Hold on, man. Do you want to tell least one of the stories that you were talking about?
Oh, shit.
It
was funny because the people used to make fun of him back in the day because he's a real eccentric fella. Real cool dude, and we used to hang out and have a lot of fun. It's funny, I've got a picture with me and another girl who went to the school, to our school back in the day, and then with Froze. And he had like on like, yeah, I think he had on like a disco outfit or whatever. But he was just that kind of crazy one hell of a funny dude. And right, people used to pick on him all the time. And it was funny because he used to do that Vulcan death grip. And Clay, like he would drop, he would do that with two people. And it's funny because now, years later, he's playing Spock actually doing it on TV. So that shit's pretty inspiring. And, yeah, I mean, he used to do it too. It's funny because he'd make the face and then he would do the grip. And you, folks, just look up the Vulcan.
The Vulcan death grip. Everybody knows a fucking Vulcan death grip. I mean, of course.
Yeah, you gotta be.
That's fucking hilarious. I mean, I don't got nothing against dude. Dude's a fucking awesome actor. I love them in Heroes.
Yeah, he's fantastic.
Love them in Heroes, man.
Yeah, yeah. And he left. You know, he left the city, went off to Hollywood, and it's crazy because when I got out here, well, you know, I saw him when I was back east. I was like, holy shit, can't believe he's doing this stuff, and then. You know, I came out here and I was like, damn, he's really thick in the game, you know, thick in the game.
How long you been out in L.A. now?
About 10 years. Yeah, a little over 10. Yeah, so.
Are you happy that one of the greatest Pittsburgh independent filmmakers is finally getting a star on the Hollywood Walk of Fame?
There you go.
Yeah, good call on that. Yeah, I mean, you know, I.
He deserved that a long time ago.
That's so true. So few people have also deserved that. The thing I love, you know, I think it's cool that folks come from, you know, towns, small towns, like where the culture is just completely different, and they come out here and, you know, do their thing in the industry.
But he never went out there though.
What's his name? Yeah. Say his name.
George Romero.
Yeah, fantastic.
And that's the guy that's with the
Night of the Living Dead, Dawn of the Dead, Day of the Dead, The Crazies, Martin, like Creep Show. It just goes on and on his list, man.
A nice fellow too, from what I hear. So,
that's the one. Like, if I could ever meet anyone famous before he passed on, that's who I would want to meet.
Nice, nice.
Justin Romero, to sit and just. Pick his brain for a tiny bit, you know, but not like piss him off.
He's cool though. I hear he's real down there, chill dude. So that's definitely he's done some great work. I mean, he inspires a lot of people. So Pittsburgh got some interesting stuff though. We got the Warhol Museum. You know, it's got a little tradition. We play you all too in some football.
Yeah. Oh yeah, and we fucking whoop y'all in a Super Bowl, didn't we?
Man, still hurting about that.
Oh yeah, I'm still smiling.
But I like, you know, I'm a Packers fan too, so I got.
Oh really? That's what's up. Yeah, man, I root for Pittsburgh unless it's against us, man. I like that as an AFC team. Pittsburgh and Raiders, man.
Oh yeah, yeah. How you do that? That's like liking. That's like liking dick and vagina at the same time.
Yeah, liking the most scummiest shit. Yeah, damn, Yuck Nasty, you get it.
You can't like both those squads, man. You can't be a Pittsburgh fan and like the Raiders. God damn. That's rough.
Dude,
they
got a good quarterback, man. Motherfucking Cosby will do his thing.
True,
I'm excited for this fucking season, man.
Yeah, me too. It can't come any sooner, right? Man.
No, dude. Dude, they got I just drive two blocks, take a right, and now these assholes are out there practicing right now. Well, not right now, but I mean every fucking week, almost every damn day. Doing the OTAs, it's almost training camp. It's gonna be up soon.
Sarah wants to come down there for training camp.
I was gonna say, what happened to Boots, man? As soon as Max Cole came on, she like, disappeared.
Football.
Tell us, Boots, what's
up,
Boots?
You guys are talking about football, right?
Say hi to Max Cole, Boots.
I'm Max Cole.
What's up?
I tried to talk a couple times, and you guys told me to shut up, so then I stopped talking.
Oh yeah, I thought that was last week. I'm sorry.
That was last week.
That's a rough crowd in here. Y'all are rough.
Oh, man.
Used, getting abused. And
see, Boost knows way too better. See, look, you're talking over it.
Every time.
Go ahead.
What?
Say hi.
I already said hi.
What were you going to say about football, though?
Yeah. I don't know. I was trying to. You guys were talking about football, right? I was just making sure I fucking hate football. So.
Ask Max Cole's question.
Uh-oh.
What? Why? What am I, like, in, like, sixth grade now? Ask him a question. Come up with something good.
Yeah, right. Hang up on Sarah.
Did I?
You look crazy.
I'm not going to hang up on Boots. I just want to make sure you give all your fucking links out earlier.
Yeah.
Goddamn, we were, like, on a fucking... I was like, damn, we're doing an actual professional fucking interview in the corner with a dogger. I'm Max Cole.
I shut up most of it.
No, man, you were fucking right on fucking most of it.
No, I really want to have a conversation with you one time about just George A. Romero films, if you want.
God, yeah. That'd be fun. That'd be good times right there.
Because, like, the very first horror movie I ever saw when I was 5 years old was Creepshow.
Oh, nice.
And I saw it on an RCA movie disc.
Remember those tapes? God damn.
No, the movie, yeah, the RCA movie discs.
Yeah.
Like, yeah, and they had the comic book, too, so I got to follow along with the comic book.
Oh, nice.
Oh, fuck. That was when my love of horror started. I was like 5 years old.
Right. What's your favorite all time? Is that your favorite?
Dawn of the Dead, 1978.
Yeah. Classic.
I don't even classify that as a horror movie, but it's such a fun movie, man.
Yeah. Yeah. How about everybody else? Everybody likes horror?
I get scared of everything.
I would rent horror movies in the 80s, early 90s, just because I knew there was some tits in them.
Yeah.
So not surprised to hear that.
You had a spreadsheet. You're like, oh, fucking Nightmare on Elm Street 4, 5 minutes.
Dude, yeah, man.
Wasn't there a website like that, like,
Mr.
years
Skin?
Ago? Mr. Skin, yeah. What are you talking about, MrSkin.com?
I just remember every fucking videotape, man. The rewind point is, as soon as you hit play, you put your VHS tape in there, and as soon as you play, it's right after the titties were, because I was right in finished Boots. What do you think about that now?
Little prepubescent pervert.
We were talking about this with Missionary, too, weren't we?
Bath times at Ridgemont High.
Yeah.
I'm saying my fucking first whack off to a fucking video was... God damn, what'd I say? Hot dog or?
You said hot dog, yeah, the gondola.
Yeah, when she came out of that motherfucker.
She whipped her titties out of that neon jacket.
Oh, Porky's, man. Fuck, dude, I remember whacking it to Porky's.
Oh, yeah.
Your favorite part is the fucking glory hole with the soap.
Hell no, man. My favorite part was motherfucking. The worms crawl in, the worms crawl out, the fucking the graveyard scene, I meant.
Do you know what my first one was? Was Revenge of the Nerds.
Really?
We got Bush. Evan's like,
a nerd told me naked. Yeah, I did, bitch. Yeah, I did.
Oh, shit, man. My son and I watched it. I think he must have been 9. It was before the fire.
Nine,
yeah.
The first
That's
movie.
That's not that bad. I mean, there's no fucking in it.
No.
Except for, like, in the moon, on the moon, but that's like.
Oh, he was dressed up as Darth Vader.
Yeah,
you mean when he kind of rapes her?
Yeah, he only kind of rapes
her. Wait a minute. Why? Why does he almost kind of rape her?
Because he pretended to be.
I'm asking a woman. Shut the fuck up for a second.
Because he dresses up as somebody else so that she'll have sex with him.
So that's considered rape now.
I was just talking about your experience.
Isn't that what happens on every date?
Isn't that how it usually works?
Only when I take them out.
Yeah, I just put my mask on and I'm like, yeah.
Darth Vader mask. And...
I got a dogger baby mask.
Dogger rapey.
Dogger rapey. Dogger rapey.
Here's a B-rated horror movie that the first time I ever saw tits in a movie was Deathstalker.
Oh my. I don't think I've seen that one. Huh?
Yeah, I don't know what the fuck that is either.
Okay, that's classic 80s, like, fucking... There's a lot of titties in that movie. I saw it when I was, like, 6 or 7.
Dude, I remember I used to be in love with, I can't think of her name, but it's Jay Moore's wife, Cox. Courtney Cox. No, Nikki Cox, right? He used to be in all them motherfucking movies back in the day, right? Nobody's not with me?
Well, yeah.
Right?
I'm about to be.
Oh, yeah, yeah, she was. Yeah, that's right.
That was like one chick I always remembered her name. Because it's Cox, maybe.
I'm down with her now.
Yeah, brother.
Getting down. Getting down.
Shout out to your
getting
wife,
down, getting more. Down.
They need more nudity in films.
Yeah, yeah, man. They need more nudity.
They need to, like...
It used to be different, though. Like, it used to be, like, a bigger deal. And now, like, you just see, like, pop a titty, and you're like, hey, that chick flash her tits. All right. Yeah. Like, nobody's fazed by it.
So it kind of got played out, is what you're saying?
I think so.
Yeah. Yeah, kind of the motherfucking, like, all the parody movies played that shit out.
Yeah, that's true.
You guys remember any of the fucking stoner movies from the fucking 90s?
Oh, the Stone like, Age?
It's the Stone Age, yeah. I remember that fucking one.
Oh, yeah.
Apple Peppermint Schnapps? Anybody?
You're damn right, dude.
And Blue Oyster Cult. That's the two things I remember the most of that movie.
Wow.
That was gotta be classy. A black girl can't. Wait a minute, I was about
whoa,
to say.
Whoa, why did you have to. Whoa, Max is now. Way to go, Apple.
I was about to say, Halle Berry only got a fucking.
I might agree.
Thing, you know, because she actually fucking Bob Thornton on camera.
Oh, yeah, she did, yeah.
That was motherfucking that real
monster
fucking.
Ball?
Yeah, yeah monster ball. Dude, there's a fucking shot where you can just see his balls still attached to her fucking ass cheek. This, like, I'm like, damn, his dick's in her. First time I watched him, I'm like, damn, his dick's in her. And then she gets what, a Grammy, Emmy, whatever the fuck it's called?
Yeah, she got an Oscar for that, I think.
Oscar there.
Yeah, like, this is my new favorite movie.
I whacked into that motherfucking movie.
I thought you were talking about 90s stoner comedies.
Yeah, we flipped, man. You gotta follow the brain.
You forgot about Dazed and Confused. That was, like,
oh,
one of the
yeah,
past
dude.
Ever.
Dazed and Confused, for sure.
And Half Baked. That was awesome.
Oh, yeah.
Would you consider National Lampoon's Senior Trip a stoner movie?
No, I would think...
See, you know that's... I think more road trip would be.
Yeah. Yeah.
Really?
A little bit.
Even Dude, Where's My Car would be considered a 90s stoner's movie.
Wow.
Or that's one, Biodome.
Oh my god, I could probably recite almost the entire movie of Biodome.
Yeah, it's classic.
I know who somebody's gonna be single soon.
He's leaving your booze. You fucking
he's...
keep talking about domes. Yeah.
I like Biodome.
There's more, though. Come on, guys. Help me out. I can't. I'm gonna...
Dome within the dome.
80s stoner movies. There's
80s.
80s.
Or 90s, sorry.
Watch Beyond the Valley of the Dolls. That's a 70s movie, though. That's a way old flick.
I've seen that.
Yeah. That's not like... That's not a stoner
movie. That's like an LSD movie, though.
Clerks, would you call that? It's the 90s.
Well, yeah, Clerks for sure.
Yeah.
Yep.
Friday, definitely.
Anything like all the movies back in the 90s made stoners be. So anything where it's like some dude is getting her like.
What about Friday? Yeah, yuck? Sir. That's probably what it's the fucking pinnacle one.
Which one?
Friday.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah. Friday was different, though. I mean, that was a black film. I mean, I'm sorry. I mean, you know what I'm saying?
That's a stoner movie.
It was more of a gangster fucking film.
No way. That was a stoner flick, man. That was a comedy.
Just because he was getting high today doesn't mean it was a motherfucking... Alright, so getting back to the point I made earlier. Like, when I think of stoner movies from the 90s, I'm thinking of dumbass fucking... Dumbass motherfuckers trying to fucking perpetuate that shit when you're a fucking idiot.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Him going into his the bathroom where his dad's taking a shit isn't hilarious enough?
Yeah. I don't know. I'm just telling you my opinion. Why are we talking about taking shits in stoner movies? I mean, fuck.
this funny?
He's like, man, I'm gonna convince you. Remember when he took a shit?
Well, I thought the weight of your heart is poo.
I just remember the air freshener.
Just remember the air freshener.
Yeah, dude.
Okay, but there's got to be a few others. Like, I want to hear some more. I like this topic.
I got about like 10 minutes left on 8 minutes left on a mix.
Okay. So, we need a couple more 90s stoner movies.
That's a hard one. That's a tough call.
I mean, that's it. Like, Stoned Age, Dazed and Confused.
I can't think of it anymore.
Two movies? What about
Stone to watch that movie. Oh, goddamn. That's not a stoner movie again. Evan, do you want some sausage? Evan, do you want some sausage? Alright, man. Max Cole, thanks for calling in, brother.
Man, it's been a pleasure, folks. You know, I gotta sign off.
Yeah, man.
Hit me up and if you wanna do that, we'll do that.
I'm always good. I'm down with that. I love a little good film discussion. I'm gonna bring Yuck on the show too. I'm gonna bring you on the show and talk. We'll talk some cinema too as well. Maybe
we'll do a Romero show. Seems how you're from.
Oh my, that'd be good stuff.
Yeah, man.
All right, folks. Well, have a good evening. You know, and masturbate.
Damn right, masturbate penis. Thanks, brother.
All right, peace out, folks.
A penis.
All right.
Is it that?
There you go.
I like that guy.
Dude, Max Gold is
Yeah, he's so chill, man.
Yeah, dude. Fucking awesome, dude. And he's on the twat box at Max Gold Films.
Half Baked is a 90s stoner movie, though.
Yes, it is.
That and like, Dude, Where's My Car?
I already said that. But that's. Gay.
Yeah, you already said that. That's gay.
Did you guys ever see Two?
No, that's gay.
Two Dudes, One Cup. Nope.
No, 2 Days in the Valley.
No, never.
Really?
Very really.
Fuck. Now you're asking movie questions after Max Colt leaves.
Well, I can't ask movie questions when there's like a professional on the phone.
Oh my God.
I was a professional.
She was over there banger bang.
That bean is so flicked.
Blasting. not banging, blasting.
I'm just over here flicking a bean. Just flicking a bean. Flicking a bean.
Booting the bean.
Hell yeah. Salute back to you, fucking Max.
Yeah, cheers, Max. You're a great guy.
Yeah, dude.
That's like
fucking
that
awesome.
Fucking Michael Corbin son of a bitch.
I don't really know who that guy is.
You know what? Russell, call in.
Is he still here?
Yeah, he's still here.
Russell.
Russell, the love muscle.
Dude, I will refresh. I will refresh my shit if you call in, Russell.
Russell, call.
Ooh. I'm still recording, man. I'm definitely gonna chop motherfucking Max Cole's fucking interview into the goddamn downloadable podcast. And if Russell calls in, dude. Yes,
yeah, Russell, call in, man. I want to say
I'm
going to
fucking make sure that shit gets it there.
Call in, Russell, please.
The Max Cole part could be like special download.
Oh, my God. Wait till
bonus
you hear
content.
The fucking guy that makes boots flicker bean.
Boot,
4555239 Skype, man. Add me on Skype. And there was a Luke V that called in earlier, man. If you're still here, motherfucker.
I'll have
you
sex with you.
You're welcome to call back again. I'm about to refresh my shit.
That's a big deal.
Refresh your shit. I'm going to talk for... It's only 11:30. I'm going to wake up at 7:45, so I'll have...
listen to anything I say.
Yeah, right. We was just like,
well, that would make all of that sense.
The best is like, I was like, and Sarah's gonna say something in 3, 2, 1, and then Sarah's like, Evan, really? He's like, yep, no.
Whatever. So unpredictable. So are you. Shut up.
Wanna fight about it?
I think it was a good job. I don't think he was making fun of you.
Who?
You making fun of Boots.
No, I don't make fun of my girlfriend.
Yeah, you do. All Russell, the time.
Russell, call back to the corner. Skype in. Get in the corner.
Russell.
It's a Skype name.
Russell.
Yeah, can you play some music like you were playing earlier?
Okay.
No, because it skips, because I can't freestyle over it. Fuck you,
what,
Sarah.
Just something that's underneath us, or you want to hear a song?
I just liked the beats you were playing earlier. They were good.
Yeah. See, again, when we bring back video, I was even saying this to the chat room that I was talking about being in with Max Cole. When we bring back video, man, I want help. I need help. I even told this to Evan and everybody, man. If there's a fucking idea that we could do, you know, something stupid that might be funny on video, some type of skit that we can just fucking take and piss all over it and make it whatever the fuck we want, man, let us know, because
you will do that.
It's a good idea, right, Boots?
You will go to there.
Well, do that. All right, 347.
You.
3474.
I'll fucking share my number.
Oh, what? My God.
Well, welcome to the corner. Talking. Who is this?
It's Russell.
Oh, Russell, baby! Where's my sound effects?
Fat, drunk, and stupid is no way to go through life, son.
Faggot! What's up, partner? Welcome to the corner.
Well, good to be here. What's going on?
No, man, we just wanted you to call in so we can motherfucking talk about you and motherfucking make love.
Hi, Russell.
I like when you're going. I like making love.
Yes.
I just want to hold your hand.
He wants to hold your cock.
Evan's not so much into the making love part as much as he is a snuggler.
Heard it right from his girlfriend.
This man has no dick.
She's she's used to the struggle snuggles now.
The struggle snuggles. He just wakes up in the middle of the fucking sleep and he's like, yeah, baby, I struggle.
She's like sound asleep.
Or maybe not.
Two rooms down. And I'm like, I'm coming. I kick the door. I'm like, come on, snuggle with me.
That's what you sound like.
Russell, how are you? Welcome to the corner. Is this the first time you've ever called in?
Yeah, I don't like calling into shows so much.
I like when you called in to talk to me.
I'm
thanks,
glad
buddy.
You called in tonight to talk to us.
Well, I promise you I'll call in one day.
Well, you did a fucking great job, and I'm fucking proud of you, bruh.
You never promised me anything.
Yeah, fuck Evan. What's going on with you, though?
Evan, I promised you a hand job. What are you talking about?
Yeah, whoop, man. Whoop. See, all Evan has to do is come to Chicago and stop being a fucking fembot. Bot. The bot. Femboy, fembot, you know, the same thing. And we can hang out. How far are you from Chicago?
I'm in New York.
Oh, damn. Where in New York?
Brooklyn.
Damn, right in Brooklyn?
Dude.
Damn.
Damn, I'm going to say it again.
Damn.
Dude, Russell's in Brooklyn Zoo.
Shame of Russell when he come through.
Me, yeah. Mom, you.
So how's the weather out there in Brooklyn, partner?
It's all right. Warm.
Yeah, nice and warm right now?
Yeah.
Where, all right. Where in Brooklyn do you live?
Park Slope.
Fox Hill?
Park Slope.
Foxville?
Park Slope.
Park Slope.
Park Slope. Goddamn, thank God we got a Canadian on here to tell us Americans what we are talking about.
Boots is Italian. She understands shit.
Yeah.
She's more Italian than you are.
Yeah.
More Italian than I am?
Oh, yeah.
What about you, Russell? What are you mixed with?
I was just going to say it for me. Go ahead.
He's our Spaniard homeboy.
I was going to go with steak, but all right, we'll go with that.
Oh, shit, we got another motherfucking Spaniard, homeboys, yeah. So, do you understand what's up with Mad Max when he's feeling all, like, one-eyed and stuff? Or can you even relate, like, as a cousin?
Unfortunately, I have 2 eyes.
Okay. But not even, like, family? I mean, aren't you guys, like, at least, like, 16th cousins? You and Mad Max? And Russell?
I think Russell's our...
Hey, what's up, Logan?
Puerto Rican. Hey, are you?
Bro, and he's...
Yeah, like I caught a video that he made for you during when you had the fire thing, and he sounded so different. So I'm like kind of curious to see what he is.
Dude, I'll tell you this. He stutters.
That was Jason.
He stutters a lot more. He stutters way more. Like, and he shouldn't. Honestly, he shouldn't.
Hey, Yuck.
What?
Does Jason stutter more than Yuck? Or than Dogger?
Yes, Jason stutters way more than Dogger. Yeah, man. Yeah, he stutters a lot. He's more quiet.
Yeah.
He's more reserved. But, like, honestly, you get a couple beers in him and you guys are all kicking it, he fucking acts exactly like he does on a microphone. Like, that's just him.
Oh, shit.
Not, I mean, you don't even need beers. As long as you ain't got paint, I guess, around and there's no work happening, that motherfucker is a crazy fuck, dude. Seriously.
Why don't if you can go to Chicago, man, go for it, dude.
Who, me?
Yeah, you.
What the fuck am I gonna go to Chicago for? I already deal with the bullet.
Well, fuck, dude. Bullets. You're on every fucking chat room Mixler has to offer. So you might as well go and say what's up and jump on and say hi to everybody.
No thanks. I like living.
Like, you live in Brooklyn.
I know.
Brooklyn's not too bad anymore.
Yeah, not anymore. You know, that's the Bronx. That's a shithole.
Yeah, you guys, like, just took over a bunch of land and built some new houses, right? And high-rises and shit.
Nah, that's
really? That's cool. I don't know anything about, like, the boroughs. Is it the seven boroughs? Is
Do you
that
know
what
that they're called boroughs?
Yeah.
Yeah, because I listen to Wu-Tang like a motherfucker. But what are the seven boroughs? There's Staten Island. There's Queens. Brooklyn. Bronx. Harlem.
Manhattan.
Yeah, Manhattan.
Well, what's the seventh?
Five boroughs as
well. Only five.
Oh, well, why did you...
Queens.
Well, I said five, then.
Brooklyn.
Shit,
only five.
My bad, go ahead.
No, I said already, Keith.
Yeah, I haven't talked too much. I thought you said, let me talk.
Yeah, no, I talk way too much, dude. I want to hear you.
Nah, Evan, you don't talk enough. I need to hear more of you.
Exactly, dude. More, right? Evan. Right, man. Evan needs to start his own podcast. Now that he's back to the house.
Do you know who I picture Russell as? It's Fat Joe in the movie Empire. Just sitting on the couch with a shotgun with, like, his kid playing PlayStation.
Hell
and just,
yeah!
PlayStation.
And then anyway, he comes in, he's got just like the bitches coming in, sucking his dick, whatever, he just fucking, you know what I mean? Like, and everyone comes fuck with him.
I know what you mean.
But Tretch from Naughty by Nature is gonna end up killing fucking our boy Russell.
Aw, that's impressive.
Wait, what?
So what do you do out in Brooklyn, Russ? Hey, Russell, what do you do out in Brooklyn, man? You got a family? What's going on?
Yeah. No, I got kids. No, I got no kids.
Okay. Right on. What you do? You out there working?
Yes.
And you grew up in Brooklyn?
Yeah, pretty much.
Right on, man. How old are you?
27.
Holy fuck, you
hold on, recall in two. I want to talk to two Hondurians at the same fucking time. Yeah, I want to hear you guys. I want to hear you guys talk Hondurian, and then me and Yuck and Sarah are gonna try to guess what you guys say.
Fuck yeah, I'm a perfect translator when I do not know what's going on. I meant to.
No. We got the trans. Are you down with that, Russell? You're cool with that, right?
Sure. What the hell?
Fuck. Come on, Reed. Call in, man. Fucking. You guys are the best. You two are always on every
show. Yeah, exactly.
Who did you try to play this game with before? Was it Mad? No, who were you trying to play this with before that it didn't work?
You and Mark in Detroit and Jill.
Oh, no, it was just June. Yes. It was just June Takayama.
Yeah,
and you were like, June said something in Japanese, and he was like, what? And you're like, no, I'm not supposed to know. We're going to guess.
Boots. Man.
What?
You are doing a great job.
Am I?
I'm trying
really hard, so that makes me feel good.
You know, hey, alright, so you guys know I was gone last week, and I must have repeated, ugh, damn women, probably like 30 times, because at the end of the fucking vacation when we're coming back, Isaac's like, yeah, I know, damn women.
Why did you say, ugh, damn women so many times?
Because I was only around all women and little fucking teenagers that are finally just getting their period. I mean, just, and they're all synced up.
You, Sarah, and Jill?
Oh, yeah, me, Sarah, and Jill, our periods are linked up, synced up, and everything.
You have to take two pens?
Yeah.
Moon time.
Yeah, there was this one time that my period actually synced up with June Takayama's.
One time, Yuck and me touched cross streams, and you should never cross the streams. We were like, fuck it, let's try it out. We'll see what happens.
Come on, Rhett, call in. Goddamn, Rhett.
He said, give me a second.
Oh, okay, I didn't see that, man. I was about to start building you. Thanks for telling me
not
to.
I'm sorry, do you want me to hang up?
If I wanted you to hang up.
What you say?
So, motherfucking Russell's a love muscle.
How do you say your last name? Zavala?
Yeah, Zavala.
Fuck yeah, I'm a pimp.
Hell yeah.
I know how to speak Hungarian. Yeah.
You know, I get it. Yep. I love all the fucking memes, man. The memes, dude. I love them. Especially that none of them are about me and they're all about Dogger. That's my favorite fucking part.
Well, see, Dogger gave me the best picture. I can't do that with your Jill. You don't have dumb pictures.
Dude, I love the one where it's, oh, so how do you tenderize a dick? And she's like, oh, with her teeth. Shut up, bitch. That's my favorite one.
Well, actually, I think Sarah was actually on that one.
No.
Fucking.
Yeah, you were.
Were you talking about tenderizing dick with your teeth?
I'm in one.
You were.
Yeah, you were.
I'm internet famous.
No, you didn't. Oh, Jill said God. It, but you were there talking about it.
Oh, I don't remember.
We didn't hang up on her, don't we?
Sometimes I say words without thinking, especially when I'm talking to these people.
You became internet famous when you were on that Glenn Dudes podcast. Tell them all about it. We want to hear the links, and I want to send everybody here that listens to the corner to fucking listen to you and Glenn on that fucking podcast.
Why?
Evan, what is it? Evan, what is it? She did a podcast with some dude named Glenn, all right? And I know I'm fucking up, but it's some dude named Glenn. If we fucking listen back to it, Evan and I and Boots and Missionary from Wrestling Soup, And we just totally ripped on her, like, every second. Like, I just kept pausing, and Missionary's like, so, this fucking bitch, blah, blah.
Yeah, it was funny.
It was a good fucking night. So tell everybody the motherfucking podcast that we're talking about.
I don't know what it's called.
Evan, where are you
right at? There?
Yeah, what is Glenn's podcast so we can link everybody to Glenn and fucking Sarah's episode that we pissed all on when we listened back to it?
Talking about.
You don't fucking know?
Talking about.
Talking about? I just gotta say proper so I know how to spell it.
That's the name we're talking about. That's the name. Just go to geeksoftheindustry.com. It's the greatest industry of all time.
Geeks of the industry.
It's called Talking About. So fucking suck my dick, you little fuck.
Dude, fuck you, you cocksucking ass white man. Calm the fuck down or I will come over there and hump your fucking leg. Like, if you're right here and you fucking start cursing at me like that, I would stand up, smile, and I would just fucking dry hump you.
Can we look at each other in the eyes first?
Geeks of the industry, only if that's planned. So go to Geeks of the Industry and look for
dry hump my leg.
Glenn's podcast called Talking About. And what is your name on there? Is it Boots or is it Sarah?
It would be Sarah.
Wow. How sweet.
Where's Rick?
It's actually Talking About.
Where's Red?
Talking or Talking?
What is Geeks on the Industry?
I don't know, an industry of geeks?
Okay.
I think it's just like a podcasting district.
I had a show
podcast
on.
Distributor.
Actually,
you don't know what it is?
I had a show on their network.
And you don't know what it is? Awesome.
Where's Russell?
It's totally
Ah, Russell, my boy. Where's Rhett?
Yeah.
Who knows?
Rhett.
Oh, Rhett. It's Rhett, Colin? Man. Motherfucking DJ Chuck the World called him Rhett. Make sure to follow them, motherfuckers, if you want to. I am 216 Radio on the Mixler.
He's always like, Evan, my nigga. I'm like, no, I'm white.
Another 347 area code.
Yes.
You motherfuckers are neighbors, aren't you?
Yo, what up, man? Oh, shit. Yo, what's good, man?
What's up, Rhett, motherfucking? Rhett, what's happening, partner?
Hey, Rhett.
Yo, what up, everybody? Damn, son. I popped the cherry finally, huh?
There you go, man. Everybody's
see what happens when I come on your show, yuck? Bring people together,
man.
Both.
Hey, as long as all of us can, like, hold each other's hands.
Sarah's gonna blow us off.
Sweet.
Yo, Sarah.
Yeah.
Oh, shit.
So welcome to the corner, you motherfucker. What's going on, pimping?
Nothing, man. I'm walking to the deli right now. You know, I just got follow up.
What kind of sandwich you gonna get, son?
What time is it there?
It's like one something.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's about to be two.
You guys are from the same place, and Reed sounds so much more gangster than you do, Russell. Come on, get it going.
Okay, you say gangster? You wildin'. Nah. I was born and raised in Queens. I actually work in Brooklyn.
Right now you work there?
Yeah, right now I work over there in Brooklyn.
Which McDonald's?
Where you work?
Which McDonald's?
The one right across the street from Burger King.
Stupid. My bad, man. I just the door was open, man. I had to just walk in there.
You're an idiot. You don't know the street to the bowling alley.
Yeah, right next door is a Wendy's.
Right on, dude. I like Wendy's.
How often do you have to spray those shoes? Great at the bowling alley that you work at.
What?
2 times a day.
That's not too bad. Yeah.
I hope you're making fun of my laugh because I took it like that. I heard beep 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 and I'm like, oh, that's Yuck's laugh. That went nuts. So, man, what's up with you fuckers?
Yeah, man. Thanks for calling in, guys. I appreciate you.
He does.
No, no. Anytime, man. You know, sometimes I'd be a little nervous, you know, so I just call in.
Don't be, man. Yeah. We're going to fuck with you the same way we're going to fuck with anyone else who calls in. So, man. You know what
and
I mean?
You fuck with us back, man. That's a corner, dude. All is love, man. It ain't no, like, oh, no, did you just hear that asshole who got off the phone? Oh,
hey, Yuck, guess what? Both these guys are in the Evan Hill fan club.
Oh, my God, are they? Yeah. I am, too.
Me, too.
Yeah, motherfucker, Peter Peters. That's me in there.
Oh, my God, it's like a fan club reunion.
Facebook banned my goddamn fucking name.
You should have just made another one that said your name again. Like, why did you make one that said Peter Peters?
I was pissed, man. I said, fuck them.
If you used your real name, it probably would be banned, too.
No, you man. Can't say. Fuck Facebook, man. Facebook got me in trouble with my girlfriend, man.
Oh, wow.
Did Facebook get you in trouble, or did you get yourself in trouble?
You sending Russell dick pics, and Russell fucking sent them to your girlfriend?
Nah, man.
Wait a minute. No. He sends Russell fucking dick pics, and fucking Russell just posts all sorts of memes about him. That's how you found out?
Yeah.
No, I want to hear what did Facebook do to get you in trouble with your girlfriend?
So you know I was bored, right? And you know it's like 5 a.m.
Oh, no.
So I'm just bored out of my mind, you know.
Bored,
at
man,
midnight
you know?
Is when I get my greatest, like, you know, I come up with the craziest shit. So I was like, let me look up mugshot. You know what I'm saying? So I'm looking up mugshot, and then I'm trying to look up my ex's mugshot. So I'm thinking I'm typing on her name wrong or whatever. So just to make sure, I looked up on Facebook. And then the next day, my girlfriend is talking to me normally, and then she's like, oh, you want to be stalking your ex at 5 a.m, right? And then I got caught. I was like, damn. So I was like, I didn't tell her anything. So then I finally told her, like, listen, I was bored. I was trying to look for mugshots of different people. And she was like, my ass, fuck out of here. Go keep stalking her and this and that. So Facebook got me in trouble, man. Fuck Facebook.
Does anyone else feel like they're in the movie Kids with all these fucking New Yorkers? I feel like
I love that movie.
I feel like me, Ree, and fucking Russell are sitting in the subway right now, and I have no legs.
I have no legs.
It's stupid, bro.
Wait a minute. I want to know, how did she find out that you're even looking at anything?
Yeah, I guess on a laptop. It shows when you search somebody. That's what she told me. I don't know.
Yeah, your internet history? That's how you got busted?
I don't know, man. She's a professional at that. So I was like, dang, son.
Oh, my God. Hey, dog a baby reincarnated with the stupid technology. See, you are that fucked up, man. You are more fucked up than dog a baby. He knows about internet history.
Yeah, look. Not for nothing, but I'm a little, like, you know, I might be a little young, but I really don't be, like, on the social media shit. Like, I really don't know how to do a couple things, so, you know, I don't know how to delete all that shit. All I know is how to post, write, share, and that's it.
Well, why is he fucking tripping?
Rule number one, you don't join the Evan Hill fan club if you don't want to get in trouble.
Yeah. No, but she won't. If you join, though, that's all private what he posts in there.
Yeah.
You can't see that shit unless
she's in
there.
How old are you, Reed?
I'm 25.
Old is your girl?
She's 23.
Oh, okay.
Is Russell still here?
Yo, yeah. Russ, what up, man?
What up, homie?
I thought you two were supposed to talk Hondurian, and we were supposed to guess what you guys were saying to each other.
Yeah, we went off on something for a minute, huh?
Or Spanish.
Oh, Michael Corbin, what's up, bro?
He was on the air, he's boring, so we're here with you guys now, so let's play this game.
What are you talking about? Evan, you said you love Michael Corbin.
Yeah. I'll fuck him in the ass, but, I mean, that's as much love as I'll give him.
Hey, just like motherfucking Rhett just said, man, sometimes you get bored and you gotta move on.
Sorry, Sarah. Corbin.
Sometimes you get bored. Sometimes you gotta look up your ex-girlfriends.
Yeah, she got me in trouble.
Yeah, dude.
I'm sorry, but Corbin's tension is just popping.
That's Jesus. Cool.
Okay.
He said, fuck yeah, I'm a power bottom, and I was right there.
You were all into it.
Okay, can you guys speak Spanish or something? Just
No. So, alright, dude. What the fuck is going on? How the fuck are you guys feeling? Do you guys want to act stupid, or you just want to answer stupid Evan's questions?
No, I don't care.
For hours.
For hours. See,
that means answer Evan's stupid
questions. Dude, I was trying to play a fucking sound effect for Evan, but it didn't fucking play. My bad.
We should play Family Feud right now.
Oh, shit.
Russell versus Reed and Sarah. Let's do this.
I'm down. You guys are down?
Down?
Sure. I'm down.
Let's do this. Who's on my team?
I don't know. You just divvied him up, motherfucker. What the fuck?
Yeah, you're not figuring it out, man.
Me and Russell versus Reed and Sarah. Let's do this.
Okay. Reed, I'm very competitive. We better win or we're not friends.
You're going down, you bitch.
Fuck you, I hate you.
Oh, yeah! You motherfucking writers, get the Kona podcast. My name is Peter Peters! It's Dumbassville! And we about to bring you the best shit ever. Fuck everything else. Goddamn, motherfucking right. I'm the host of the best motherfucking show. And if you got a problem with that, you suck Reed's dick. Okay.
Whoa.
Yeah, motherfucker. So here we go. We got the Evan Hill Boots family over here on my right. Say hi.
Nope. We're the Wu-Tang Clan. Me and Russell.
Oh, you and Russell. You and Russell are the Wu-Tang Clan. Yeah, on my right.
All
right.
Right.
And on my left, we got motherfucking Team Canada.
Yeah, slash New York.
Slash Brooklyn.
Oh my god, they're both Team Canada slash New York.
Fuck you, Sarah. You're going down, bitch.
Hate you.
You damn right.
Okay.
All right, motherfucker. We in the corner, so motherfucker, we have Evan. Step up, and we'll have motherfucking Reet. Stand up. Come on, bring your motherfucking come up to the thing right here. And let me know, hey, you gotta let me know. What does your buzzer sound like, baby?
Tinga!
Alright, what's yours, Reed? Right on. So I understand whose buzzers is whose. We're gonna start off with theirs. Okay.
Hey, what's up, buzzer, Evan?
Tinga!
Dinga.
All right. I don't know.
That's just
it
his
sounds
buzzer.
Like
your buzzer can be different when it's your turn.
Ding dong.
Ding dong. All right.
Well, we
do
asked.
Whatever the fuck you want for your own buzzer, bro.
No fighting. Anyway. Calm down. No fighting amongst the family, okay? We're trying to play a game. All right. We asked 50 fucking meth head bitches. We asked them all. 15 meth head bitches, okay?
Okay.
What is a word that you normally hear after the word crack?
Zynga!
Alright, the Wu-Tang family buzzes in. What do you got, brother?
Please.
So, we're hearing... You want to hear crack, please?
Yes.
Hey, we're going for crack, please. Is it up in that bar? Oh, hell no, motherfucker. I don't know where this asshole is from, but I know it's not where these meth-head bitches that we talk to. They're not crackhead bitches, if he heard it. So, back to the motherfucking Team Canada, Boots and goddamn Rhett. What are you thinking about, Rhett? What's your answer, partner? What do you think is the fucking 15 meth head bitches said? What is the word that follows the word crack?
Crack. Help me out, Boots.
Head.
Yes, I was thinking that too.
So you're going with crack head?
Yes.
Oh, shit. Wait a minute. There we go. Yeah. Forgot the fucking buzzer. You know, we got like little people working for us. They don't understand what's going on. But yes, crackhead is the number two answer. Are you guys going to play or are you passing?
I think we'd like to play.
Oh, okay. You're playing. So, all right. All right, Boots. Again, we got two more answers up here on the board. We asked 15 meth head bitches from Detroit that's dated Mark. What is the word you are used to hearing after you hear the word crack?
Whore.
Oh, you goddamn right. Crack, whore, that's the number one answer. If I said the other one was the number one answer, I was wrong. This one is. Yeah. Oh, there's one more answer right there. Back to Rhett. God damn it. Now, you can't use Boots for your motherfucking help, partner. You got to do it on your own, man. I believe in you. I'll give you 15 seconds on the board right now. What is the fucking word that normal motherfucking, you know, everyday fucking meth head bitches hear after they hear the word crack?
Kills.
What is it?
Kills.
Crack kills?
Yeah.
All right, well, we looking at you meth fucking sluts thinking about crack killing them. Wait a minute. Oh, here it is. Oh, yeah, Dick is fucked up. I told you about the midges, man. They're on strike, so we got some union workers in here. But no, that shit ain't on there, motherfucker. Oh, back to Boots.
Russell, we got this. You ready for this?
Come on, Boots. Oh, come on. What's the word that follows crack, man? Come on, Boots.
Oh, yes.
Crack what?
Pipe.
Oh, good. Pipe?
Crack pipe?
Man, it's not on there. I'm sorry.
I don't know.
We only ask meth heads, not crack heads. Did I not fucking say that already? All right. Back to you, Red, one more time, motherfucker. What's the word that follows the word crack?
Addict.
Crack addict?
Yeah.
Addict,
yeah.
Like addicts, like I got an addict in my house, and so do you.
No, like addicted.
Oh, that's not it, dude. There's no music for that one. The midgets are pissed. Hey, the fucking union workers are pissed. They didn't even add music to that motherfucking buzzer.
We're coming in for the steal.
All right, that's three X's for these fucking guys.
Russell.
All right, so Team Wu Tang, what is a word? That mother... I hope you guys huddled, okay? I'm going to say it one time, and it is your time, all right? So what is word that normal motherfucking everyday meth addict sluts hear after they hear the word crack?
You got this, Russell?
No, you get...
No, you got this.
Who's the leader of the family here?
Evan.
Jizza.
Evan.
Okay.
Somebody say answer. I'm gonna motherfucking.
No.
Crack no?
Yeah.
That is probably the stupidest answer that's ever been said on Dumbass Feud. Why would anybody say no to crack? I mean, what the fuck? Oh my god! Alright, so the motherfucking Canadian Boots family takes on that win. All right, this motherfucking round is worth tripling. Then we're going to the speed round, and you don't know what's going on with the speed round, motherfuckers. Goddamn right, are we ready? All right, so we got Russell is a love muscle. Let me hear your buzzer, Russ.
Ding dong.
Very fucking good one. I understand it perfectly. And Booty Boots, what is your motherfucking buzzer?
Ooh, I know.
Very Canadian of you. All right. So, let's get to the motherfucking question. Come on, midgets. Where's my music? All right. So, here we go. We asked three guys. And the three answers is on the board. So... What is one thing that your wife has a very big thing of? What is something? What is something that your wife has a very, very big thing of?
Oh, I know.
Oh, well, we hear boots over there in Canada. Let's go ahead here on the wireless.
Yoga.
Big yoga?
Dildo.
Big dildo.
Yeah.
Remember, we only ask three men.
Yeah. They probably aren't satisfying their wives. Disappointing. Just like those dudes.
I swear to God, there's not three men out there alive that's thinking about their wife's dildo. Too bad you put a female on the buzz of this round, Team Canada. All right, so here we go. Russell's love muscle. Just remember, you do not have to use your buzzer right now, brother, but tell me, name something that a husband always talks about his wife having something big of. Her big...
clit.
Her big clit?
Yep.
Holy shit! That's on there. That's number three, because we asked Wiener from the corner, what his fucking wife had. He said, a big clit, because he likes to get poked in the fucking eyeball with it. I don't know, but that's what happens. So that's the number three answer. Dylan, that's for you. All right, next to you, Evan Hill. Come on, baby. Bring it on home. Tell me
bitches
something.
Got big mouths.
A big mouth?
You big ass.
You goddamn
mouth.
Right. That big mouth is number one. You goddamn right. Man, there ain't no man thinking about her big ass dildo. It's a big fucking mouth that never shuts the fuck up. Okay? Goddamn fucking big mouth running out of fucking time. It's a fuck, fucking shit. Fuck, fuck.
Shut your big mouth, bitch.
Oh, my bad. I just got a case of Tourette's all of a sudden. Yeah. So, that's number one. The number two answer is still on the board. Russell's the love muscle. What do you think the only other dude that we ever asked, and I'll tell you, it's Dogger Baby. It's actually Dogger Baby, so that's a good hint for you. What do you think?
Can we have a family?
Men always complain about their wife having something big. It's her big what?
Big shit.
Oh, come on.
I don't even know how to respond to that, ladies and gentlemen. He lives in Brooklyn. He's from some Pittsburgh or somewhere, I think he said. Or maybe that was Max Cole. I don't remember anymore, but anyways.
I like bitches.
All right, back to Evan Hill. Come on, she's got a big what?
Big ass.
Big asses! It's that motherfucker! Man,
you didn't ask.
Holy
any
fuck! She's got a big ass. She's got a big clit is on there. Well, I told you we only asked three dudes, specifically three dudes, and I just gave you a hint. Dog is the second dude that's not on there. You think he's going to talk about her big ass?
Sarah was one of them dudes.
Oh!
Yeah.
Hey, Russell, I hope you're getting a lot of memes right now, baby. So, what do you think Dogger Baby would say that his wife has a big something of?
I don't even know.
Fuck, you don't even know.
No, I know. Like the fact that happened.
Oh, wait a minute. Wait a minute. There it is. Well, yeah. He fucked up. That's his third strike. So back to Team Canada with the Brooklyn
Let's
motherfucking
get it.
Gangster. Okay. All right, so I hope you guys are huddled. Which one of you is going to tell me what you think it is?
Reed is.
Oh, I know.
Your wife has a big what, Reed?
Big dick.
Of course. See, he knows what Dogger Baby is going to fucking answer. You got that right. The motherfucking Team Canada in Brooklyn to sweep the shit out of Evan Hill and his motherfucking buddy Russell's love muscle. You guys suck. You guys suck.
At least Sarah came up with fucking meth whore.
Crack whore.
Oh, yeah, and she had the wrong answer, remember?
Oh, yeah, whatever, then I'm not interested.
And pipe. I was going to say ass crack, but...
Crack ass crack?
Crack ass crack?
Crack ass crack.
Where's Russell? What did he say? Why doesn't he say anything? He's like the worst family member I've ever had in my life.
Yeah, I got a question. I got a question for you, Yoke.
Go ahead.
Hey, why does everybody like hanging out with the mushrooms?
tell me, why does everybody like hanging out with the mushrooms?
Because he was a fungi.
Dude, Max Cole is ready to cast you in his next film, bro.
Oh my god, holy shit, what are you doing stand-up?
Oh, you fucking asshole.
Hey, this is for Mad Max. Hey, Mad Max, what do you call...
Mad Max, call in.
What do you call Mexican stepped on poo?
Mad Max?
Hey, puto. hey, another one. Hey, Max, this is for you. What do you call a Mexican with a rubber toe? Roberto! Now.
Yeah! Is that, yeah.
I get it, yeah. I guess.
It took me a minute.
Keep going, man.
It took me a minute.
I wanted to greet fucking Russell talk. They're not too far from
Yo, Russell, we gotta meet up one day, bro.
Alright.
Yeah, man, go to the dollar store.
You guys should wear your wrestling soup shirts together.
Yeah, we should go to a bar, wear the wrestling shirts, and take a picture, post it on the Emmett Hill.
You're damn right, man.
And not expect to get any pussy whatsoever.
There's no pussy
well, yeah,
in there,
if I'm wearing a Joey number shirt, of course I'm not going to get nothing.
Well, is it because of the big nose? Are you making fun of his big nose? All right,
you guys
man.
Just going to talk about wrestling soup
now? No, well, I'm done. It's, man, I'm fiddling my motherfucking mouth full of something.
What? Cock?
I'm done. I need to eat the rest of this sub that dog had left me. There's
yeah.
So much
actually, yo, actually, one last thing about wrestling. I think, you know, Hornswoggle?
Yeah. Hornswoggle?
Yeah, the little midget.
He said Hornswallow. Yeah. Yeah, Hornswoggle.
Jill Swallows. Nah, but Miss earlier.
Jill Swallows? Yeah, I know about that. I heard about it.
Oh, yeah, no. Miss hit me up earlier, and he was like that. I sent a Hornswoggle a question, and Miss told me that he answered it, so I'm looking forward to that.
Right on. Missionary.
Are you famous?
No.
I want to be
famous. Internet famous, probably, no.
I thought he said Seamus.
Seamus? Oh, he
I
want to
be Seamus.
He was Roxton in the new Ninja Turtle movie.
Seamus?
Seamus was.
This is just deteriorating right now.
Yeah, man.
Sarah, do you want to have sex with...
Seamus, Seamus?
All right, we're done, man. I'm going to hit fucking stop on this shit. Thank you, motherfucking Russell. Thank you, Ray. Thank you, Boo. Thank you, Emo. I'll find you later, bro.
Later, hey, before you
yeah,
hang
definitely,
up,
man.
Hold on, go ahead. What were you saying?
Yeah, I want to fuck the soccer baby one day.
Yeah, dude, of course. You call in.
I want him to, like, you know, shit all over me so I can get those horrible memes of him.
You damn right, dude.
Yeah, dude, me too. You... I want to ask him, how many butt plugs can he butt chug? I was just wondering, you know?
Oh, shit. Man, I bet he'll try to set the world record no matter what it is. Hell yeah, man. You guys had a man. Thanks for making my fun fucking night, all for you. And all of you guys listening, man.
Yeah, yo, thanks, man. Thanks for having me.
And I'll tell him,
I'll tell him, man. You guys have a good night, penis, everybody.
Bye.
Yeah. There I go. I just hit stop on everybody. Yo. Yes, sir. I'm gonna motherfucking eat my sub. And I'm gonna fucking pass the fuck out. Again, thank you for fucking with us. Always. I think I might play a song and fuck around. No. I'm gonna play some music before I get the fuck out of here. If you guys wanna leave, you leave. Otherwise, you can listen to the music and then I wanna listen to it while I'm slamming my motherfucking sub. If not, thanks for fucking hanging out. Yeah, baby. Mm-hmm. Yeah, baby. Yeah. What's up, motherfuckers that are still here in the chat room? I'm gonna play some shit that I've been fucking with. I've been recording like hooks lately, and I'm gonna hear them. And, you know, you guys are fucking close enough that I can play some shit for. Some shit that ain't right yet, but that's what I fucking wanna hear right now. And that's what I'm gonna play. Since I'm bringing the fucking program up. Alright, I know it's gonna sound fucked up, but you guys are used to hearing us freestyle and trying to find hooks with it. You know, I've been finding beats lately and just been going crazy. I mean, I'm not making up words every fucking time. And, you know, I need to add words to where these syllables are. But I want to fucking play this shit, so I don't give a fuck right now. You'll be able to follow it, and just imagine a song written this way. I mean, this is just me freestyling it, and it's pretty good. I know everything's off tune, and I know I don't hit, I'm not on tune every time, so again, a lot of words that don't mean sense.
Oh, hey, oh, 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 oh
just getting laid late. I'm just getting these wrongs, yeah, yeah. I'm just getting it on daily. And feeling these calls, say, yeah. I said it's sitting on your babe. Do this shit when I get like this, this. I just wanna be this and this, this. Get a son of a baby, get rich, rich. I just wanna see it. Sometimes I need the melody to ride, ride. Remind my ass what I did before. That hot shit that went somewhere was lost to the ether. Goddamn, yeah, I need to do some more like this. Cause my flow be outrageous, bitch. I feeling your motherfucking vibe. I wanna come over and sit high. But I feeling I can't do that. Your man over there looking ruthless. I'm just laughing inside, but maybe I should get back to like this. Yeah, hey, when I get like this, when I feel when I get like this, yeah. I can't believe this shit I'm on when I get like this. Yeah, like this. Oh yeah, yeah, like this. I can't believe this shit I'm on when I get like this. Like this. Like this, yeah. Like this, can't believe it. Shit, I'm on again like this. When I get like this, when I get like this. Ooh, shit, I'm on when I get like this, baby. Everybody gets one time to get this shot. When they hear this shit, they better hit. As long as a fucking kid, a motherfucking kid, right back to the boom, man. So I wanna get something like this. Man, let me know what you guys think about that shit. Alright, that's obviously just a fucking stupid freestyle, just so it's a reference track, so I don't forget what I was doing. You know, I usually, when I come up with a hook, I fucking record a reference track so I don't forget. But like, here's one of them why I just went nuts, and like, everything that I was doing felt so right to the beat. To where it was motherfucking, you know, building to where it needs to be. Hell yeah, man. I fucking wanted to share that with you motherfuckers. I like that shit a lot. I like it a lot. See, I still got some minutes left. Yeah, thanks. Thanks, man. All I gotta do is add some motherfucking words to them syllables. Hold on. I see, I know Boots heard this hook before. But since the homeboy Max Cole is still there, like I have a fucking hook that I want to fucking show real fast. Let me show my ass off and then I'm out of here. But this song, this hook is totally for a fucking movie. Not that one. Not that one. It's like no one's ever fucking used these words and said this phrase and used it in a song before. And that's important for a fucking hot lyric to become a hit out of nowhere by nobody.
memory of me fades. Will you hold on to it, babe? I hope you hold on to it, baby, for always, yeah. If the memory of me fades, will you hold on to it, baby? I hope you hold on to it.
Fuck, I fucking hit the wrong button and it motherfucking stopped. Oh, shit. Oh, well, you motherfuckers get a teaser of it. How many minutes do I have left? 3? Alright. God damn. I'm gonna play it again, because that shit is fucking powerful, man. Fuck it, here we go.
Memory of me fades. Will you hold on to it, babe? I hope you hold on to it, baby, for always, yeah. If the memory of me fades, will you hold on to it, baby? I hope you hold on to it, babe, for always, yeah. If the memory of me fades, will you hold on to it, babe? I hope you hold on to it, baby, for always, yeah. If the memory of me fades, will you hold on to it, baby? I hope you hold on to it, babe, for always.
Yeah, motherfuckers. My bad for the loud microphone right there. That's my little fucking hook. That's my motherfucking best quality. That's my talent. That's where my strength is at. It's fucking just riding with a beat, hearing it, and writing a fucking hook. Before I fucking suck my dick anymore, I got 1 minute and 35 seconds left. Here's a song I did once called Come All Over Me. Yes, come all over me, and I'm gonna end it on this.
Come all over me. Come all over me. Come all over me.
Say it again, girl.
Come all over me. Come all over me. Come all over me.
You know I will, girl. What the demo, love?
Come all over me, come all over me, come all over me.
Say it again, girl.
Come all over me, come all over me, come all over me.
You know I will, girl. What the demo, love? Let's go get it done. Fuck with your boy, I make ya. And in the car, I make ya. And at the bar, I make ya. In the bathroom, make it happen. Pick a stall, I make ya. With my pinky, with my thumb. Should I leave it? Use my tongue. I ain't scared. Tell me where, and I'll be there to make it. Work your finger, make it quiver, mommy. Show me how it's done. And don't you stop it till your body shit the thing.
Come all over me. Come all over me. Come all over me.
Say it again, girl.
Come all over me. Come all over me. Come all over me.
You know I will, girl.
Come all over me. Come all over me. Come all over me.
Say it again, girl.
Come all over me. Come all over me. Come all over me.
You know I will, girl. Don't pretend that.
Come on.
good luck.